When I first start teaching a kid how to hit, I oftentimes compare it to how a kid throws. Today I'm going to show you how throwing and hitting are very similar. In the first step of throwing, where does your weight go? It starts to shift back. The same thing happens when you start your swing. Your weight starts to shift back, very similar to throwing. The next step of your throw, once you've loaded back, is to take that step forward, to take that move here. Same thing when you swing. If I'm in my stance and I've loaded it for my swing, I take my step. What starts to happen when this front side of my body moves forward for that step is my back elbow starts to separate from the side of my body. And it happens for both hitting and for throwing. So I'll walk through that one more time. I'm here, I'm in my load, whether I'm hitting or I'm throwing. I take my step, my elbow is separated from the side of my body. And here's the huge critical point that a lot of hitters can't seem to get in their swing. From this point here, you would never tell a person throwing to spin on their backside and release the ball. The number one reason you don't want to tell a kid to spin is because they obviously are going to lose that power. They're going to keep most of their weight back. Same thing goes for hitting. What you want to make sure your kid's not doing is they're not squishing the bug. They're keeping their weight too far back. They're not utilizing their power. What the hitter's power drive teaches kids to do is to not squish, but more to step and push. And that click allows your hitter to know, I'm pushing, I'm not squishing.